What up, though? What it is? What's popping? What's happening? What they talking about? What it do? It's the kid, the big dog, Jay Better Artist, man. I feel blessed, man. I got a local artist in the building all the way from Miami. Just kind of down the street. Zoe Dollars is in the building. What up, though?
What's up, bro? What's popping with you?
What's popping with you, man? My brother is fresh off tour, smelling like a bag of money, man. What's good, man?
Yes, sir. Nobody safe tour. My off day. You know I have to pull up somewhere with it.
Pull up on me then, man. So who are the people you on tour with right now, man?
Me, Future, Tory Lanez, ASAP Ferg, Migos, Young Thug, and A Boogie.
You definitely sound like a situation, man. You're definitely doing big things. Speaking of big things, man.
Yeah.
The record, man. Talk to me about that.
Bad Things, my new single. My prior single to that was Blow a Check, of course, Run Through the Money Rhyme. That's out of there.
Mm-hmm.
And now we got Bad Things for the ladies.
Bad Things. Now the record is definitely hot. We definitely playing it on the station.
It's going up.
The ladies is feeling it. I'm feeling it too, man. It's like a cool vibe. You know, it's kind of like laid back. And you on there singing a little bit. Got the vocals on there like that, man. So what inspired you to do that record, man? Where did you come from with that idea?
You know, just me being from the island, man. You know, we got the island in us. It's a Caribbean thing, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then I decided to put out a record for females this time.
Right. The ladies is always going to support you more than the fellas.
Radio hit,
yeah, definitely.
Made that route.
Mm-hmm. Definitely goes both ways. So, what's the project? What's the upcoming project? You got Bad Teens as the single.
Yeah, I got the remix of Bad Teens about to come out.
Okay.
It's me, Tory Lanez, and Future on there.
Oh, wow.
And then I'm about to drop a new EP sometime. I was supposed to drop it on May 18th, but due to some clearance issues, I couldn't drop it because of the clearance issues. So we waiting on the label to get everything together, and then we're just going to go.
Okay, you got a release date or a name? I'm sorry, a name?
No, we don't got no release date yet.
A name?
I'm actually on the process of a name switch right now. So
okay.
Once we get that clear, I'm going to have that for you.
Okay. Now, when you hop off tour, man, you got any upcoming shows in the city coming up?
Yeah, tonight we doing Rumbus.
Okay.
Palm Beach, pull out, man. Come out, man. You know I'm going to pop out.
So you the headliner there? Any other open acts?
So it's a few other people. I think my dog Tweezy on there.
Okay.
A few other people on there. You know, salute to everybody grinding, trying to get somewhere, man. Last year, I wasn't where I'm at right now. So.
Okay. I definitely see you doing big things. I was down at, where was that? I was at the Chris Brown, I believe. You came up on the stage and performed as well.
Breezy brought me out. Breezy and Fab brought me
Yes, out. Man. It was definitely something crazy, man. You brought the city out. In Miami was definitely in the building.
Yeah, I heard. I mean, I couldn't hear. When you on them stages, you can't really hear the crowd because you got the ears on.
Yeah.
So you really just performing. You performing for them.
Right.
You can't hear them.
Right.
You're hearing yourself in the levels and shit like that. So my homie was like, yo, when you came out, they were crazy.
Yeah, and when you go back and watch the video, or you know, you see somebody snap or Instagram, like, oh, I had it like that.
Yeah, I did do that for somebody. A lot of snaps and IG videos was coming in.
Definitely, man. So I gotta ask you the question. I wouldn't be doing my job if I wasn't, man.
Do it, man.
You recently was on a radio show, man.
Do it, man.
And it was some shots fired at Joe Budden, man. And you told him he couldn't come to
the city. I didn't even fire shots. I just made it clear, like, if you keep popping shit on the internet. You say the wrong thing, you ain't gonna be able to come down here, period.
Where did that all stem from? Is it something he said to you directly?
See, I was born in Miami, I was raised in Haiti. Where I was raised, in the area I was raised, in the village I was raised, you don't accuse somebody of nothing until you have proof of it.
Mm-hmm.
You can say something and just that saying get that person killed.
Mm-hmm.
And if you call somebody a thief, the whole village is gonna burn them the fuck down.
Mm-hmm.
So you gotta make sure you have proof of what you're saying. And the person that signed me, that changed my life, which is L.A. Reid, he gave the okay to sign me. He was calling him a rapist, you know, because of some allegations. I don't care what you hear about a man. As another man, if you don't have proof of that, you can't call no man a snitch, a rapist, or gay. None of those things that, you know, that's going to downgrade your character or your brand. You know, you got somebody who changed not only my life, Future's life, Travis Scott's life, a lot more people. And I'm talking, those are new people. I'm talking about a lot more big people in the game, like legends in the game. You don't come out your mouth and disrespect that man. If nobody else gonna stand up, I'm gonna stand up. Mind you, I don't have no problems with Joe Budden, just to make that clear. But if he go out his mouth and say some shit like that, then we gonna have a problem.
Now, is there anything that he can do to reconcile the situation? If he give you a call, has he hit your line up?
Listen, if I have an interview with Joe Budden, I'm gonna sit down and talk to him man to man at the end of the day. I'm a man, like some of the biggest people that done died in squash day situation. And us, we don't even have one yet. Until he come out and say some next shit. I mean, he did come out on an interview and said, fuck $30. But then again, that's because...
Oh, he did?
Yeah, he was on the interview and Academics said something about, you know, shout out Zoe and Zoe. He was like, fuck $30. And he kind of like sideswiped the Haitian. So right now, I got the Zoes on his ass. You know how that shit goes.
It may be a problem.
Just be safe, Joey. Just be safe, Joey. That's all.
So, for example, would you do a record with Joey?
With who?
Joey.
Would I do a record with him? What we gonna do to pump it up?
Y'all wanna pump it up one time?
We'll
like
do a pump up remix?
Yeah, I'll pump it up one time, you know what I'm saying?
No, we ain't gonna do
come
that.
Come in with the old man flow, y'all do a little thing. Bad thing
nah.
Remix.
we gonna let old man Joey be old man Joey.
See Joey, man, he just, you know, he a critic now. You know, he falling back, he just observing and he just giving his criticism on what's going on. Cause you know he's not really out there right now, so.
Yeah, that's just want Joey to be safe. And it's a few people from Florida that's like, oh, you don't run Miami, you don't run Florida. And then you niggas bring Joe Buttons to Miami and see what happens to him and y'all.
Speaking of the city, moving forward, man, how is the city treating you? Because you know a lot of local artists, they come from a local city, they can't come back to the city where they just hating, people hating for no reason.
Man, you get
you know,
hate.
The love.
The hate comes, the love comes. I focus on the love, I don't focus on the hate.
Right.
Focus on everybody that's supporting me. I focus on getting new people to support me. I don't focus on none of the hate, because the hate, if it comes my way, it gets dealt with.
Right. You got to keep that balance, man. I see you on the jet skis. Shout out my man Lex Promotions, man. I see y'all out there. Shout out Smiles Official, too, man. I see y'all out there. He was just up here like a couple hours ago, man. We was all kicking it, man. But I see y'all out there doing things, man. I got to come down there and get on the skis.
We got the biggest jet ski party on Monday.
Yes, I seen it. You, Meek Mill. Y'all was out there. Yeah, Tory.
This is the third one we doing. This just some stuff I started. It's like a wave. I'm like, you know what?
Yeah.
I've been partying since I was 16, 15 in clubs in Miami. I'm 26 now. That's like years of partying in the club. Let's just do something new. Let me start some new wave. And I was sitting down with Puff, and he told me like, Zoe, how about you do this?
Yeah.
He like, you from Miami, man. It's your city. It's an open city. Start a new wave and do something different. And I just started saying, you know what? We gonna bring 100, 200 jet skis together, four or five yachts.
Yeah.
Pack them up with nice chicks.
Yes, sir.
And all my dogs come on the water. I don't care if you beefing with each other. When you get on that water with us, it ain't none of that. Everybody just free. Everybody just riding. Everybody have fun. It's no ego.
Yeah.
It's no bottle popping, so nobody's flexing on each other.
Yeah.
It's everybody there to have fun.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Hey, I don't know about everything free, because I was asking. I was like, yo, how much it cost to get on jet ski? He like, yeah, $300, $400 for the whole day. I said, player, the way my bank account set up.
If you don't get on the ski, you could easily catch a ride on the boat with
somebody. Hey, man, I'm not riding on the back of a jet ski, dog.
I mean, hey, I feel you on that, dog.
Hey, just let me get on one of them boats, man. We're going to have to link up.
We got you.
The funniest thing, man. I shout out Lex again one more time. I seen him pull up with a box of Bel Air on a jet ski.
Yeah, man.
It was the funniest thing.
Lex,
man.
Lex got one of the fastest jet skis in Miami.
Yeah, man. I see him on it all the time. So moving forward, man, besides the music thing, is there something else that you want to get into? You know, Lily Dollars opened up his own business, clothing brand, movies.
I got my own water company now.
Okay, that's
great. We definitely gonna merge into the movies. And when I got some free time, I'm gonna finish my aviation school and get my pilot license.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So if I hop on a plane and you the pilot, like,
here we go.
I was like, do you drink or smoke?
Yeah, I don't drink or smoke either. So.
Oh, for real?
No.
But you came out with this song, Drink and Smoke. So that's for the ladies.
I'm asking.
I can provide it, but maybe I don't indulge.
Do they drink and smoke?
Okay.
I don't do it. You listen to my verse, I said I don't do it.
Okay. Now, is there any maybe a possible endorsements that you could come up with, partnership with them?
Whoever bring the bag and whoever's going to help the brand be bigger than what it is. Anybody I can help that can help me, That's what I'm looking forward to. But as for now, nah, we don't. They're on the table, but we ain't partnered up with nothing yet.
Okay. Well, I appreciate you sliding through, man. I'm excited about the new single, man.
Yes,
Bad
sir.
Teams blowing, running through the check, man. You holding it down for Miami. Definitely the new generation,
oh,
the young
Florida,
boys.
Man.
You know, you done had the trick. You done had Trina.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? Rose's doing this thing, too. But you got to have that young generation
definitely.
To come in and hold it down. So salute to y'all, man. So if there's one thing that you can say, you know, it's always local artists out here that's trying to get on.
Word,
man. And what do you give them, you know, based off your success story? Maybe how did you get signed or found?
My advice to all artists is just, if you see somebody who got five times more than you, all you got to do is work five times harder than them. You might catch up or pass them. And just stay humble in the process and work harder. That's all.
Right.
If you work hard, whatever you working towards is going to show.
Definitely.
And if you plan, it's going to show too, because you're going to stay where you at.
Mm-hmm.
A year going to tell you the difference in all the work you put in. Just 1 year is going to tell you exactly how much work you put in.
So set up this time.
Yeah, just put that time on and then work and give it a year and see where you at.
Definitely. So shout out your handle, your Twitter, Instagram, your Snapchat, where people find you in the music.
I'm Zoe Dollars on everything. Just follow me. You know, if you interact with me and I see it, I'm definitely going to follow you back. I'm not one of those Hollywood artists that's not going to follow you back to look cool. I follow everybody back. On Snapchat, I follow the whole world back.
I think I seen you post, like anybody that posted, I follow the first 10
of them. Yeah, I be on that. I be following everybody back, especially my fans, people that support me. If you just follow me because you want to see the lifestyle or you want to see what artists do or... Cool, I'll let you follow me, but I ain't gonna follow you back. But if you a fan, I'm following you back. For sure.
Definitely. Y'all hear that? All the fans out there, man. Follow my man, Zoe Dollars. Bat teams out there, man. The man, the Miami, the Memphis. Do you like the party? Do you get real high? Can I touch your body? Oh, what's your name? Can you handle when the whips start switching lines?